dosage of alkaloid tranquilizer you have prepared may be added now, if you wish.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, I don't think we need to do that. Go ahead.
Okay, is that gonna work? Oh, look what we got. Well, it looks different. Maybe he'll not recognize it as being the boxed food.
A prepackaged meal which has been dosed with tranquilizing alkaloids.
Should work. Mr. Spock?
A reprocessed cellulose-based container with prepared nutritional components inside appropriate as a meal for one individual. In addition, the food has been heavily laced with drugs, particularly in alkaloid tranquilizers.
The music in this room so reminds me of like old like Nintendo, like Final Fantasy or Dragon Quest games.
As a meal, the food in this little box is a tad high in carbohydrates by human nutritional standards. Still, it would supply about 1/4 to 1/3 of a day's average caloric needs, and includes protein, fats, fiber, a bit of spices and flavorings. There are also drugs in the food, some of which we added, you know. It's quite heavy on the alkaloid tranquilizers.
That's what we're talking about, added. Alright, so this path...
Save new, replace previous...
...is 5, and we're gonna... Hope this works. And we'll give it to her.
Tuskin will only accept food from you. You said you'd help us after we helped you. Would you give this to Tuskin? It's heavily medicated, but that might help Dr. McCoy here to do something so he's better off.
I'll take this to Tuskin now because I trust you. Go back to him and show him your food. He'll call for me, and I'll give him this instead. He'll be a good boy.
All right. Maybe I need another thing out of here, I'm not sure.
The machine whirs. Lights.
I'm not sure if I'm supposed to show him a box.
The box of prepared food.
Or show him the berries. So, we've got a box and berries. So let's go this way. I'm probably going a long way around, but whatever. Actually, no, it should be right on the other side here. Nope, through here. Still surprised we can't do anything with these plants because they're like poisonous and stuff. Let's go save on that
save
path again.
Replace.
Protect me. They're after.
We'll hurt you.
We really.
Captain, cut.
The Klingon.
Yeah. These guys might actually be on our side. I don't even know.
I am hungry. Maul? Where's Maul? I don't take nothing from nobody. Nobody except her. You'd do something to it. Make me different. You'd rewire my head.
Here's Maul. She won't rewire your head.
Call for me,
much.
Tuskin? I thought you might be hungry, so I brought you something you could safely eat. You know you can trust me, Tuskin.
Yeah.
Oh, what a liar.
I know I can. And I am hungry. Didn't want to eat something I couldn't be sure of, though. Give me that.
Please. Take your medicine now, like a good boy.
Now I want to take a nap. Maul, you watch out for me, okay?
Sleep again.
Captain Kirk, don't waste your time or mine. I expect more than that of you.
Hmm.
Save new game. Replace pre-
Save.
You want help from me? That's a laugh. My captain evidently-
I listen to my brother Rackaback and to my friend Tuskin. They say, well, Tuskin's just confused. I don't think I should go into it right now, but he thinks if people knew all about this place, they'd hurt his mind. Actually...
Be careful, brother. Remember that Tuskin warned us, people might seem nice, but not really be nice.
I don't know what would happen, actually. After all, I can't read the future.
That's true.
I'm more interested in a good fight than in talking.
I must admit I've met friendlier people, Bones.
Drug therapy. Primitive 21st century medicine. The people who built this ship must have thought that filling a person's bloodstream with chemicals could solve every medical problem.
I think Gormagon may hold the key to our understanding of this situation, Captain. He seems rather more reasonable than some others here.
I think Gormagon is the one to click with, Captain.
Agreed.
Fortunately, he seems pretty reasonable to talk to, or at least to interact with. Except for the way he's bullied all the time.
Rackaback seems like he could be a big problem for us, Jim. He's obviously prone to violence, and there may be no gentle way to deal with him. He's clearly unreasonable.
Okay, all valid opinions.
I am feeling a little down, Captain Kirk. But don't bother about me, I'll be all right.
The individual you're trying to talk to is collapsed on the floor, unconscious.
A rather debilitated individual, male and of middle age, presently unconscious, but otherwise unremarkable, to judge by others of his race.
Medical track order?
Jim, he has fairly extensive brain damage and may be causing paranoid delusions. It's also resulting in increased levels of hostility. His adrenaline levels run quite high, and there's been organ damage from the extreme stress.
Produced by his state of mind. What do we do now?
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Looks more healthy than most of these folks, Jim. Looks too healthy for me.
You stay away from my brother. What do you want?
His strength appears to be very impressive, Captain. I do not think I could win in a hand-to-hand struggle.
Maybe we're supposed to give him
Doesn't
the berries.
Doesn't do anything special for me, Captain.
Oh, to click on yourself?
Captain, I think there must be some other way to achieve what we're trying to do here. I can be quick and charming, Captain.
Yeah, it's all the same stuff, really.
I don't want to fight you. Got no reason to.
Are you out of your gourd, Jim? That hulking brute will rip your limbs off.
Violence is not the correct answer.
Well, I wonder if he'll let McCoy use his...
Captain, he's unconscious. I can't see any point in putting him at further risk.
Keep away from me. I don't need that. I don't want to hurt you, but I won't let you hurt me neither.
Captain, I don't think this is a smart thing for me to be doing.
Oh no, I choose that again. Ugh, crap, I forgot about that. At least I save often. Give him some berries.
Yeah, that looks good. And I am hungry. But Tuskin always...
Yeah, that looks good. And...
What am I supposed to do here? You want Blanky?
Fiendishly subtle. Fiendishly...
Will you let us advance into the room? Nope. Nope. What do I do with these guys?
I listened to my brother Rackwell. Tuscan's just confused.
Be careful, brother. Remember,
I don't know what would happen.
I'm more interested in a...
I am feeling a little...
Need a gesture of goodwill or something. What do we do?
I think Gormagon may hold the key to our...
But this is Gormagon, right?
Gormagon is a large person with a slightly cowed and uneasy... The Klingon captain gravely takes the fruit, smells it, and takes a large bite from it.
Thank you. This is good. And
yeah. Figure if they saw us, giving it to him.
I listened to my brother Rackaback and, well, Tusk.
Be careful, bro.
I don't know what would happen.
I have no idea what to do at this point.
This appears to be an unusual...
Hi there, remember me?
Uh-huh. I remember.
Tell me about the food. I think that's all for now, Stamba. Tell me about the
food. The food out of the machines can make me feel really... It all smells bad.
Tell me about Tuskin and his friends. Tell me about the place. Tell me about your mom. Tell me about the food. I think that's all...
Yeah. I don't know what the hell to do. Should I just shoot him? Stun him?
You wanna fight? Okay with me. I'll hurt you, so you'll be smart if you just stay back.
My brother's always the tougher one, and I do like he thinks. Still, I don't wanna hurt you. I'd rather not see anybody get hurt.
Captain Cut!
The Klingon Observer. Gormagon falls defenseless against the power of the phaser.
Inelegant, Captain Kirk, and perhaps unnecessary. I feel that a less brutal approach overall might have produced much better results.
You know what? Shoot the other guy. Not his brother.
Rackaback falls, defenseless against the power of the phaser.
An inelegant solution, Captain Kirk. But efficient.
I listened to my brother Rackaback and to my friend Tuskin. Well, Tuscan's just... I'm sure things would change. I'm not sure what to think of you. I just don't know if I should trust you.
Well, Gormagon, I think you should trust them. They've repaired the garden, which is good for all of us. They gave fresh fruit to my boy Stan Bob, when even his own mother couldn't manage that.
True that.
They treated us in ways churlish and unpleasant. As a personage of high standing, we say to you, Gormagon, that you should eschew their company as unworthy.
Captain, that blanket we're carrying, look how Atrioli is eyeing it. Let me give it to him and he might think better of us. I know okay. This is something you would treasure, Your Highness. To show we hold you no ill will, please accept this gift.
Smart girl.
Gormagon, neither my aide nor I came aboard this ship expecting anything but treachery and veniality from these people. They've impressed me, and I commend them to you.
Well, despite some misgivings I had, I'll accept what others have said about you. I think I should show you the way into the heart of the phase, the secret entry that Tuskin is so afraid of. I feel that something good can come of this.
Ah, look at the way he walks. Dope, 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 dope. Oh, wow. Under that hatch?
I listened to my brother Rackwell, Tuskin. I'm sure things would change. I guess I'll just trust you to do the right thing.
I am feeling a little...
Captain Kirk, you can be sure that I and my aide are most interested in examining what lies beyond the hidden door.
You want help from...
The individual you're trying to talk to is collapsed on the floor, unconscious.
I'm sure he's okay, but...
Like so many others aboard this ship, he's the victim of developmental genetic death.
Save new game.
New game. Quite a long one.
Now revealed to sight, this looks like a Jeffrey's tube aboard the Enterprise. You can get through, but it is definitely not a normal passage. Especially because it almost seems to shimmer around the edges.
Interesting.
Captain, I'm getting a thoroughly anomalous reading. This passage definitely defies the physical laws of space and time.
Are you suggesting it might be some kind of space-warping portal spot?
I am reluctant to speculate without data, Captain. I've never seen anything quite like this. The doors on this ship have given previous evidence of this kind of warping. Although the passages on this ship seem normal, they appear to curve space without resorting to hyperspace generation, like the Enterprise's engines. That represents achievements of technology beyond our own abilities.
They certainly aren't as capable in the field of medicine. These people are suffering from genetic and chemical conditions that we've been able to treat for the last century. It's barbarous to pack them into this ill-conceived generation ship and hope by the time they make the return trip that those left behind will have figured out something more humane to do with them.
Captain, if I may interject, that disparity is something we've glimpsed throughout this ship. There is a sophisticated food delivery system and a food-producing hydroponics garden. It is as if the parts of this ship don't fit together, or as if there were some purpose beyond the obvious.
I was thinking the same thing myself, Lieutenant. I'd like to have a talk with whoever is behind this.
And I also, Captain Kirk. I believe our observations have been as anomalous as yours. Moreover, I don't think the Vays are the ones we must address our questions to.
Good refresher. Enter the strange warping portal. That seems completely safe. I wonder if we could have made use with the other items. You know what? Can I... Is it... Yeah, I don't know if it's up. I guess it's true. I guess it is up. Can we take this stuff now?
Jim, given the mental states...
In other words, Doctor...
That's my recommendation.
Well, we never know what we're gonna need.
Jim, give...
In other words, Doctor...
That's my recommendation.
Alright, whatever. Probably won't let us take the dumbbells either. We can't see him behind all these people. Let's just look around in here.
This room appears strangely compressed, giving a sense of closeness that borders on the discomforting. Every wall is interlaced with what looks like a web cage of electrical wirework, with almost organic-looking nodules and bubbles. You have the distinct sense that you're inside a machine and that it doesn't seem to occupy space in any natural fashion.
Interesting.
This room appears strangely... This looks almost identical to the containers that house the Fays.
Hmm. Cool. Anything else?
This room. An opaque hemispheroid through which nothing is visible.
Huh.
This looks almost identical to the... This room... The captain is uneasy, certain that this claustrophobic-seeming room holds challenges yet to be discovered. The Vulcan's interest in his surroundings is sharply piqued by what appear to be irreconcilable spatial anomalies and discontinuities of technologic sophistication.
There's some awfully big words there.
A man whose life is devoted to organic living things, Dr. McCoy seems utterly out of his element, surrounded thus by inorganic machinery, and the uneasy sense that this too might be life of a sort.
Really?
Recognition of the broad realm of possibilities, challenges, and curiosities this room represents shines reflected in her dark eyes.
Hey, don't call her a broad.
A Klingon crewman wearing... A Klingon officer...
Yeah, I never wavers, that's why it's always the same description.
I have a strange feeling about this room. We might find a lot of answers here. The primary reason we came aboard was to find a way to stop you from landing on top of our colony on Atavus, which would certainly kill thousands of our people. Now that your external senses are functional, have you altered your plans about where you intend to put the ship down? How did your systems become damaged?
I'm curious about what your builders really had in mind, shipping off all these people off-planet. There seems to have been some shadier agenda. The eugenics wars of our own past produced some of the ugliest abuses in human history. And notorious characters like Khan Noonien Singh, whose name still resounds with infamy. How is this ship you call the Compassion justified?
I'd be interested to learn more about those who built this ship. Their achievements certainly seem erratic in sophistication, but much of it goes beyond even what we are capable of accomplishing today. For example, the Paralance medium for recording computer data is something we are only now beginning to explore. I think there's much to be learned from these people. That's all for now, Faze. I assume we can talk to you if we have more questions. The primary reason we came aboard was to find a way to stop you from landing on top of our colony on Atavus.
Yeah.
No, Captain Kirk. I will certainly not set the Compassion down in a populated area. Now that I can see it is there.
Good.
I am at present in communication with the planetary authorities.
Really?
And they are directing me to a stationary orbit until further arrangements can be made for my war